I'd like to follow up on that and actually ask Mike Heffmon and or Dan Stein to comment. You heard a list of allegations by Ms. Firth that alleges that, in fact, some racial profiling may be going on. Let's just accept as a hypothetical that everything that she has told us is absolutely correct. I presume, and maybe this is a wrong presumption, that you would disapprove of these actions. Is that right, Mr. Heffmon, Mr. Stein?
Can I respond to
that? No. I think I answered, that was my first comment.
Right. I thought that's what you said. I'd like to hear what Mr. Heffmon has to say, though, as the author of these various initiatives around the country.
We had a very good, long discussion with the Human Rights Commission on this exact subject on August 11th. First of all, I'll preface my comments, but it sounds like you're much more fascinated by good anecdotal evidence than you are about.
No, actually, we've had, this is the first anecdotal evidence we've had, and it's interesting, and I'd like your reaction to it.
Okay, so what we discussed, we actually set up a hypothetical under the Human Rights Commission. We said, well, what happens now? I said, you're going to start getting more and more complaints, really, whether this resolution goes forward or not, about immigration-type issues coming to your commission, despite the fact is that, similar to your organization, there's no statutory mandate to deal with this. So, you know, how are you going to deal with these kind of questions? I asked them, you know, have you thought about it? And they hadn't thought about it. And there was questions like, can an illegal alien maintain a human rights complaint? That's the very first statute.
Let me interrupt you, because we really only have a short time, and you're not answering my question. The question that I asked was whether or not, when you were drafting these various initiatives around the country, you anticipated that there might be this effect, and whether or not you approve of that effect, and if not, what did you do in the drafting process to try to anticipate that and prevent it from happening?
Now, the effect is, will you restate what you're calling
the effect is having people targeted based on their skin color or their national origin for specific denial of benefits, or in this case, law enforcement scrutiny based solely on their appearance or their national origin or their race.
Sure. Okay, that's an easy answer. There have been thousands of state and local initiatives. Professor Chisti's database is going to be a good one, and just in the last 2 years alone. And the practice of including a specific ban on consideration of racial, religious, or national origin considerations when complaints are being processed of those statutes, that comes from me. I have insisted on that in everyone, and to the extent, as Professor Chisti testified yesterday, that these things are being cloned, I'm very proud of that consideration. To show the bad faith of the other side, we included that in the Hazleton ordinance, for example, and the ACLU says, well, they mentioned, they added this extra layer of protection, but it's really a secret conspiracy to go after illegal aliens. So, I put that in every ordinance that I have the ability to influence or draft, and it's a protection above the level of what federal government provides. And to give you a good example of how this has played out in Virginia, the lawful presence test and the driver's license, which was one of the very first ones we worked out on right after 2011. You remember the illegal aliens sold the breeder documents to the Saudis, who used it to get the driver's license to fly the plane in the Pentagon. That's what provoked this whole modern cycle. But what happened after that? I mean, all these kinds of charges and claims and hand-wringing went on and stuff like this. And the Department of Motor Vehicles has since, to my understanding, collected data and statistics on that. And there has not been a single civil rights complaint about that procedure in Virginia since it was set up. And as far as the harassment to the ordinary citizen and the idea that this was, you know, some kind of draconian influence, the waiting time at motor vehicle departments in Virginia has decreased. So it really is.
So you disapprove of any police officers acting in the way that was described this morning, and you anticipated this might happen, and therefore tried to prevent that from happening in your initiatives. Is that summarize what your point is?
Yes, I think our bottom line is we've taken extraordinary steps, given the controversiality and developing nature of this issue, to make sure that those issues. Improper considerations, the risks of them are minimized as humanly possible.